Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic transportation and excretion. And now in this session, we will see how transportation takes place through blood circulatory system. Okay, now blood circulatory system, or you can say blood vascular system, mainly consists of heart, blood vessel and blood. Heart is the main organ, you can say conical shape, conical muscular organ, which has a size of man's fist in your body. Okay, just a size of man's fist, you can say. It is a conical muscular organ made up of cardiac muscles. Okay, it is mainly made up of cardiac muscles situated in the rib cage in your chest between the lungs. Okay, between the lungs, the heart is situated. Next is the blood vessels. Blood vessels are the, you can say, vessels which are mainly responsible for the transportation of blood. It includes mainly the arteries, okay, veins and the capillaries. These are mainly the three types of blood vessels. And blood is nothing but a connective tissue, or you can say a fluid, which is carried into your body for main. It is mainly responsible for the transportation of various, you can say, substances in our body. So one by one we will see in detail. Let's start with the heart. Now, heart is an organ, as I've told you, which is situated in between the lungs. So it very much important for us to, you know, understand about the structure and function of the heart. So let's start with the structure. You know, heart mainly is of four chambered. It consists of right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. Okay. Now, this atrium is also called as auricles. Okay. Now, these heart has four chambers. Now this four chambered heart is connected with, you can say, various types of arteries and veins. Connected means, you can see here, superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. Here it is, you can see from right ventricle comes the pulmonary artery, then in left atrium you can say pulmonary veins, from here it enters, again it goes to right ventricle, and from right ventricle this aorta is connected, right? Now how the circulation takes place, you know, understood. This is the structure. Here you can see the valve which separates the atrium from the ventricle, which is called as tricuspid valve. Again left atrium is separated from the left ventricle with the by the mitral valve. Again, as you can see, the pulmonary arteries connected with the right ventricle, but it's unidirectional flow. There is not backflow, so it is maintained by the valves. Again, it is pulmonary valve, and here is the aortic valve connected to the left ventricle. Now about its functions, you know, this superior vena cava and inferior vena cava are the veins which carry the deoxygenated, or you can say the impure blood. Collect it from the different parts of the body, and it is received by the right atrium. After entering into the right atrium, the blood flows through the blood flows to the right ventricle. Then from right ventricle it goes to lungs. From here also it goes to lungs for purification by pulmonary artery. Okay, now in lungs it get purified when it get mixed with O2. Now after that, through pulmonary vein, as you can see, from lungs it comes back to right atrium. That means the oxygenated or purified blood enters the left atrium, and after that from left atrium it enters to the left ventricles by the mitral valve. At the same time, what happens, as the blood enters the left ventricle, again same amount of blood is transferred from pulmonary vein to left atrium. Okay, so now from the blood, the oxygenated blood from left ventricle, from aorta, as you can see, from aorta goes to different parts of the body. The purified blood now goes to different parts of the body, and the impure blood is entered into the heart through inferior cava as well as superior vena cava. So student, this was about the structure and function of heart. You know, what is pulse? Pulse means the force or pressure with which the blood is forced out of the heart, and it can be felt near the artery near the wrist. Okay, many times when you touch your wrist or pressed a bit near your wrist, you can hear this pulse. They are nothing but the heartbeats. Okay, the pulse rate increases. Mostly I have felt that the pulse rate is increases during fever, or you can say during exercise, or after running you can feel the heartbeat. Now this is the stethoscope. Mostly I have seen, where you have seen the stethoscope? Yes, right near the doctor uses this stethoscope to record the pulse. Okay, now as you know, the heart undergoes pumping, right? So that is nothing but the pulse felt by you. Okay, now the pressure in the arteries is continuously went up and down. So this is nothing but the systole. It is called as systole, and next term is called as diastole. So in further session we will see about this. And you know, the normal pressure of an adult is 120 to 80. It should be from 180, from 120 to 80. Again, the depends upon the fat and anxiety which you are feeling in your body. It all depends upon that. But mainly you have to consider now here, the pulse is normal heartbeat which you feel daily, or you can just feel it now also by pressing a bit near your wrist. So student, this was about heart. We have, in further session we will see about the blood and blood vessels. Thank you.